broad area of inflow here, if it's catching it at the surface, shows that we ought to be moving into an inflow area. And our north winds are gone now.
Yeah, there's something right going on right down.
Okay,
here.
Watch that close. I want to watch. There's an area up north of us too. Hey, David, this is Val. Where do you want me when I get to 35?
Wow, look at that. It looks like a wall cloud.
Okay. What's that? log cloud down there?
Well, back here it looks like it. It kind of looks like that, though.
Okay. Okay, so Val South, right? Did you? And we are, yeah. Well, we're out of the gust front stuff, and we're back into inflow here. And we're seeing all sorts of structure over here. I mean, I don't know if this is going to get its act together on the circulation or not, but something could happen. Circulation, I think. Yeah. You know, think about it, is that is still this storm, mm-hmm. right? But all this other stuff has developed south of us. Mm-hmm. Unless we want to cover flooding in Norman, which they've already got Tom there and they've got Brandon headed that way, we probably ought to go south on 35.
But look how low that is. Yeah. Remember that Purcell day where we had the tornadoes just kind of coming out of the trees with the condensation?
Yeah.
Remember that? Oh, get these lights on.
He does. What is that? Hanging. get ready to get a shot. I'm sorry, David, I'm sorry I dropped my phone. It dropped it down on the floor and I couldn't get it muted fast enough, but I was turning around here. You're looking at that shot right there. That's what you're talking about right there. That's the gust front, that's where it curls in. If there's any circulation left, any low-level circulation left with this, it's right there in that shot. That is looking south-southwest from our location. We have driven out of the gust front, out of the 65 mile an hour winds, and believe it or not, we're kind of back in inflow right now, David. So, yeah, I mean, it's looking serious. Back to you. He came to me and my phone is beneath my feet down there. I couldn't find it. Good grief.
Yeah, it'd be nice if he had a 10-second warning.
I know. Something's going on east of us too here. What's that? Look at all this. What's right in there? See that?
It's everywhere.
Get on Highway 77. That's all we need to do. Now look up there, too.
Wow.
Thank you. sure that we're even going to have any circulation unless we're way down south,
right,
with anything. But then again, we have the Norman flooding, which is probably going to be the big event today. Hey, David. I just want to tell David, sorry about not coming on a while ago. When he came to us, I whipped a U in the road to get a better shot, and my phone went flying and was down below my feet, and I had to grab it before I muted it or unmuted it. Okay. Hey, and so right now we're at Paul's Valley, and I'm not so sure that there's going to be a rotation or a tornado with any of this stuff. Does he want me to cover flooding or keep trying to watch the rotation down here? Okay. I'm sorry, two people talking at once. Sorry, I didn't. I didn't hear what. Yeah, go ahead. Okay. All right. Sounds good. Got it. Okay. You say?
I can't find it on the map.
I can't either.
How do you say it again?
They want us to watch the strong winds.
Ask them where that location is.
Near Kreiner.
Where's Kreiner? I've never heard of it.
Oh, it's out there. I just need to find it on the map. It's west of us somewhere. It's straight southeast of Dibble.
Southeast of Dibble.
Straight west of us.
Is it coming up on your map?
Yeah.
Show me.
We came through it, I think. No, we didn't. It was Sapphire, so we came through.
Yeah, Google Maps is not acknowledging that as a town.
Gotta remember too that this wind is from the northwest and the radar's up here, so it's almost going, it's not going straight at it, so it's gonna be more.
The area is getting larger.
Yeah.
Shows 57.
Yeah, it's gonna be more than that.
Thank you.
could. Go west.
Better, like, this direction.
Yeah, we're on the south edge of town here by the McDonald's, right by I-35. And the wind is starting to pick up a little, but I mean, it's 25 maybe. Yeah, you've got all those storms south of us now, and the whole storm structure doesn't look anything like it did this morning. There's some pretty good wind over near Etowah. What's it doing? I did that in my Dodge one time and it actually stalled and started putting out white smoke, and it eventually fixed itself though. Yeah, you got some water. You sucked in some water. Just don't suck in anymore. Is it still running? Okay.
The wind doesn't move in very much.
No, it's not. I think it's weakening. You know, when you got all those other storms south of it, it's lost its structure. Mm-hmm. You know? All right, so we are in Purcell right now, just sitting here waiting on the wind, and I don't think the wind's going to make it. As far as the strongest storms now look like they're going to be to our south. Davis, Ardmore, out to Healton, Warika, severe thunderstorm warnings down there. Water's going down in Norman now. Yeah, the rain is really letting up in Norman. So that's good news if you live in Norman. The water's starting to go down. Man, there's a couple of storms over there east near Stidham and Eufaula and Longtown that are pretty stout looking right now. Also Okemah, yep, 1.25 hail on the storm near Okemah. Rain falling across a big part of Oklahoma. Yeah, David, and you are exactly right about the wind weakening out here. So we are in Purcell. We're on the south side of town, I-35. And, you know, the wind that we had, the 65 and 75 mile an hour wind as we came from the west between Chickasha and here, and that was pretty constant. It has weakened a lot. And right now in Purcell, the wind is down to about 20 or so, if that even. And also the rain has let up a lot. A lot of street flooding in Chickasha when we came through there. Some street flooding in Purcell earlier, but all of that is pretty much gone right now. So good news if you live in Purcell. Back to you. So, let's just recap a little bit what we've seen and what's going on while we're kind of at a pause right now. Earlier today, when the storms got going out near Clinton and started diving hard to the east and southeast, so we were seeing 70 mile an hour winds, maybe more than that even, power flashes as we were going down Highway 152, I believe. out near Colony in that area, turned south, went down to Anadarko. But before we did that, we saw a pretty good area of rotation. Matter of fact, you might have seen a funnel with it, and it was rotating right where the gust front wrapped in. That got occluded. We went south. We got golf ball size hail in Anadarko, and they got hit pretty hard in Anadarko with hail and wind. It was wind-driven hail. Also, some flooding also in Anadarko. Speaking of the hail, we just want to thank our sponsor, Belter Roofing, and let you know that if you live in any of these areas that have hail damage, just give them a call. They will come out and do a free roof inspection and tell you whether you do or don't have hail damage. They are experts in dealing with the insurance companies, and best of all, they're a good Oklahoma-based company, and you can trust them, and that is Belter Roofing. So, we are in Purcell, and the storm has really weakened a lot here. The wind has calmed down a lot. The rainfall rates have gone down also. Everything is kind of shifting off to the east. So, looking at where the heaviest storms are right now, I need to go back to TLX. Okay, so the heaviest storms right now are that area. There's a severe thunderstorm warning basically all along this line from Shawnee, Seminole, Maud, Holdenville, Kanawha, and then on down to Ada, Roth, Sulphur, down to Springer, Davis, and then westward to Healton. And you people in Ardmore probably need to watch it because it's all headed your way. And then on down to Warika, Ryan area. And there's wind with it too. That's the leading edge. And also there's a line of storms developing, or have developed, extending pretty much along I-40 east from, say, Cromwell over to Okemah. Hail size in the Okemah storm is 1 inch. And then going on eastward from there also over to Lake Eufaula. Probably don't want to be out on the lake right now. So looking at some of the rainfall totals, and they should be pretty impressive. Okay, this would be a 12-hour rainfall accumulation, just which does not include yesterday morning stuff. Three inches out by, I'm going to say that's probably Weatherford. That's the highest that we have right now. There's a big area, though, right there between Clinton and Weatherford and Hydro of well over an inch and a half. 2.8, I believe, at Butler. $1.69 in Norman, officially. Look at those dew points in Southeast Oklahoma, 74. right, so the storm north of Ardmore. Half inch hail. Winds passed through us and it really wasn't much.